Today I am going to discuss about Android UI layouts. The basic building block for user interface is a view object which is created from the view class and occupies a rectangular area on the screen and is responsible for drawing and event handling. Means when we drag any control, the rectangular area is created on the design mode, and this area is responsible for drawing and event handling. And view is the base class for widgets. Every control, view is the base class. So many controls you know already, text view, edit text, checkbox, radio button, and these widgets are used to create interactive UI components. View is the base class for widgets which are used to create interactive UI components like buttons, text fields, etc. The view group is a subclass of view. I already explained that it is a container and provides invisible container that hold other views. Means view group means collection of views, and it also contains another view groups. At third level, we have different layouts which are subclasses of view group class, and a typical layout defines the visual structure for an Android user interface and can be created either at runtime using view or view group objects, or you can declare your layout using simple XML file, .xml file, its main layout, which is located in the RES folder under layout. That is linear layout, relative layout, view. This is also a linear layout, means view, view group, and other views also there. There are number of layouts provided by Android which you will use in almost all the Android applications to provide different view, look and feel. Linear layout. It is a view group that aligns all children in single direction, vertically or horizontally. Vertically or horizontally. That is, when you declare any linear layout, for example, linear layout, then orientation you have to declare that horizontal or vertical. If you declare Android colon orientation is equal to horizontal, it display number of columns. Android dot colon orientation is equal to vertical, it display row wise single column, and here multiple columns, and here single column multiple rows, here multiple columns single row. This is the linear layout. Another layout, that is relative layout. It is a view group that displays child views in relative positions. Means Android relative layout enables you to specify how child views are positioned relative to each other. After one by one, it will display. Then table layout, rows and columns. Rows and columns. Android table layout going to be arranged groups of views into rows and columns. Table row element to build a row in the table. Each row has a zero or more cells. Each cell can hold one view object. Means this is one row, another row, and third row. Row 1, row 2, and row 3. Table layout containers don't display border lines for their rows, columns, or cells. Here another layout, absolute layout, exact position, exact locations of xy coordinates. And it is harder to maintain as compared to other layouts. Frame layout, if you want to show area on the screen to display a single atom, that is a frame layout which display single atom. It covers area as a single atom. Frame layout is designed to block out an area on the screen to display a single atom. Frame layout should be used to hold a single child view, because it can be difficult to organize child views in a way that's scalable to different screen sizes without the children overlapping each other. You can add multiple children to a frame layout and control their position within the frame layout by assigning gravity to each child using the Android layout gravity attribute. You can arrange multiple controls into frame layout. And control the positions of all the controls using Android layout gravity attribute. Gravity attribute, and gravity is equal to center. Then another attribute, another layout, list view already I covered, and grid view rows and columns, two dimensions grid atoms are not necessarily predetermined, but they are automatically inserted to the layout using a list adapter. List view and grid view are subclasses of adapter view, and they can be populated by binding them to an adapter which retrieves data from an external source and creates a view that represents each data entry. So many views, 7 views are there, layout, linear layouts, 7 layouts are there. Here layout manager for the view arrangement. A layout manager is responsible for the layout of itself and its child views. All the layouts are controlled by layout manager. The base class for these layout managers is the Android view.viewgroup class. The most relevant layout managers in Android are constraint layout, linear layout, frame layout. These are the important layouts: constraint layout, linear layout, frame layout, relative layout, and grid layout. And it is constraint layout provided by external library. Layout files are stored into res/layout. A layout resource file is referred to as layout. A layout specifies the view groups, views, their relationships and their attributes via an XML presentation. Because XML contains the layout name, layout type, all the controls, attributes. That is a simple layout example, relative layout. Here, any layout, Android colon layout width defines the width of the widget, and Android colon layout height defines the height of the widget. Views can define their size. This can be done in units of measurement or via predefined layout example, 100 dp. Suppose match parent and match parent and wrap parent, two values are there. Match parent value tells the application to maximize the widget in its parent. It is inherit from parent. The wrap content value tells the layout to allocate the minimum amount so that the widget is rendered correctly. This is wrap content. Suppose you drag, it is the minimum area is covered by the text wrap content. And match parent, suppose Android colon layout is equal to match parent width, that is it covers whole area, match parent. And Android colon layout height is equal to wrap content. Height means दिस हाइट, दिस विड्थ एंड हाइट एक्चुअली हाइट, इट कवर्स एक्चुअल मिनिमम एंड देन एंड्रॉइड लेआउट विड्थ इज इक्वल टू मैच पैरेंट. दिस इज ऑल द एरिया इज कवर्ड वेन यू यूज मैच पैरेंट. हाइट इज इक्वल टू मैच पैरेंट, हियर मैच पैरेंट एंड रैप कंटेंट. हाइट इज रैप कंटेंट. इफ एंड्रॉइड कोलम लेआउट हाइट इज इक्वल टू रैप कंटेंट, सेकंड डायग्राम. फर्स्ट एंड्रॉइड लेआउट अंडरस्कोर विड्थ इज इक्वल टू मैच पैरेंट, इट कवर्स होल एरिया रो वाइज, हियर इट कवर्स कॉलम वाइज. This is height and this is width. Here, if two values are match parent, then it takes whole area. Layout manager constraint layout. Constraint layout is provided by an external library. It allows to use a flat view hierarchy and its great performance as compared to other layouts. It is easy to arrange the controls using constraint layout. Constraint layout allows you to define constraints for views. This is the example for constraint layout. This is frame layout. All child elements on top of each other. This is a single area covered by frame layout. Linear layout. Orientation is vertical or horizontal. Vertical. This is, if horizontal is used, the child elements are laid out as indicated by the following picture. Multiple columns and single row. And if vertical, multiple rows and single column. Relative layout allows positioning the widget related to each other, one by one. Grid layout, row and column. This is row and it arrange all the icons, rows, columns and cells. Scroll view also is there. In Android, first we have to see how to create linear layout. Here you create new project, give name of that project linear layout. Suppose, for example, in design, use linear layout. And properties are there. Android colon orientation is equal to vertical. And tools context, layout height and layout width, match parent, match parent. Here text view and edit text is there and button is there. This is the only static view. No event handling is there. How to display using linear layout? In code, we have to define. When you create any control, then it assigns one ID to every control. And we have to find view by ID, that is r.id.showInput. Suppose button, its name is showInput. Edit text and text view. Text view. These are the ID for every control. You can search that ID and then assign to one variable to arrange controls. Here, after executing this, it shows this output, enter your name and show. That is, orientation is vertical. If we change orientation is equal to horizontal, see the change, horizontal. horizontal. It shows, but when you use horizontal, some controls design is required for another view and button. Here, linear layout you already understood. Resources files. See the resources here. Drawable layout, meet map and values are there. Drawables, layout, meet map and values. Values contain colors, strings and styles. Meet map icons. Drawable, you have to copy images here. And layout, different layouts you can design here. RES drawables, images or vector drawables or XML files which scale automatically with the density of the Android device. If you want to take any images in your program, then copy images into drawables files. If you want to assign any values for strings, colors, dimensions, styles and static arrays of strings or integers via XML files. Each type is stored into separate file. Strings are defined in result values strings.xml. Layouts, result layout. Styles, result values. Result animator, raw data and result menus. This type of resources are there. Every relevant resource in the RES folder gets an ID assigned by the Android build system. Android system is assigned one ID for every control. When you drag any control, then it assigns one ID. And that ID's entry is automatically done in r.java file, which is a system generator file. You can't change that file. If you add new resource, the corresponding reference is automatically created in r.java file. Manual changes are not necessary here. Here, if a view needs to be accessed via Java or Kotlin or XML, you have to give the view unique ID via the Android:ID attribute. The name of that your control, that is Android:ID is equal to @+ID/button1. This is the identification for your control. To assign a new ID to a view, use the Android:ID and then give name. By conversion, this statement creates a new ID if necessary in the r.java file and assigns defined ID to the corresponding view. Result values. Here, suppose you have to give the value, name of that ID, then it will automatically enter into that file. That is layout files. Result values. Here, atom name is equal to button1, type is equal to ID. It will automatically enter into file. I hope you understood all the concepts from today's lecture, that is different layouts, and we have already seen that how to display output using linear layout. Linear layout, here you see the output. You have to change vertical or horizontal to design our controls. Thank you.